Hi everyone and welcome to Ms. Lala's classroom. Today we are going to be solving equations by trial and error and we're going to check that our solution is correct. So the first thing that I always advise my students is to every single time you have variables, always enclose them in parentheses. So my first step for this problem would be to enclose that variable in parentheses, because now it's more clear to see that we're going to substitute something into m, not into negative m, into m. So what can m be to make this a true statement? So let's just try a number. So I don't know, let's try 5. So if we notice, we have the opposite of 5, which is negative 5. Negative 5 plus 4 is negative 1, which does not equal to 3. So that cannot be a solution. So what was to happen if we were to put in a negative number? Then this will become positive, but then that number will be too big for that. So it looks like we might have to be working with a 1. So let's try, can m equal 1? The opposite of 1, negative 1 plus 4, does that equal 3? 1 to the left, from the left go 4 to the right, positive 3. Yes, and 3 does equal 3. So what are we plugging in for 1? I mean for m, we are plugging in for m a 1, and that is our solution. So let's look at this one. This negative again has nothing to do with your variable. What square root can we find an answer to that when we add 3, we get 0? So let's try, I don't know, the square root of 4. So the square root of 4 is 2, right? Because 2 times 2 is 4. One number times itself gives you that number. So bringing down this 2, this negative, you must also bring it down. So negative 2 plus 3, that's 1. And 1 does not equal 0. So it has to be something else. So if we start seeing here, we need the opposite of this number to get 0. So the opposite of 3 plus 3, the opposite of positive 3 is negative 3, so we need a negative 3 here, which means the square root of 9. Let's try that. And yes, we got it. 0 equals 0, which means what are we plugging in for y? Y must be 9, not negative 9, because we plugged in here a positive 9, so y must be 9 for it to be a true statement. So hopefully that was helpful. The problem here is that students don't want to keep trying, don't want to be plugging in numbers, they want to get the answer instantly. And sometimes that's not the way it goes. You just have to keep trying and keep going, putting in more solutions till you get to the answer. And that's kind of like a significant thing, because isn't that how life is? You just gotta keep trying and trying and trying, and don't give up. That's the point. Don't give up. Your girl Lala saying arriba la vida and subscribe.